Welcome back to the course. In previous lecture, we studied about image representation, what do you mean by digital image processing, and historic development of digital image processing techniques. In this lecture, we'll see some of the examples of digital image processing, where it is applied in many applications, and fundamental steps in digital image processing. So let's begin. So today image processing is used in a lot of applications like image enhancement, restoration, artistic effects, medical visualization, industrial inspection, law enforcement, and human computer interface. Let's see one by one. One of the most common use of DIP technique is to improve the quality of the image by removing the noise or sharpening it, or basically we are trying to make it visually more pleasant. And this is a subjective process. It depends on the user and it varies with the users. Like one fellow might feel like this much enhancement is enough, or another person may say no, we need to improve it further. So it's a subjective process, but this is the most common technique of image processing, which is used widely used. You can see the example here. So this is the input X-ray image, and when you enhance it, you can see the bone fragments quite easily in the rib cage. So in this, so compare this and this. This is the input image, quite dark, and you cannot see all the bone fragments inside. But in this, it's quite clearly visible. So it's the medical field. And here, this is the photo of a PCB, and it is noisy. By using a median filter, you can remove that noise, and it looks quite good after filtration. And one more application is in satellite imagery or aerial images, where you can see here the input image is too much bright. It's hazy. There's a fog in between the land and the camera, so it is looking whitish, so that it is masking or it's clear, creating a glare. So you can use image processing techniques to enhance the image by removing that white glare, and you can quite clearly see the things below, water, road, or tree area. So all these things can be quite clearly made visible by using digital image processing techniques. Another example of image enhancement was in Hubble telescope. Hubble telescope was launched in 1990, and the idea was to send a telescope into space so that we can get rid of the distortions or haze created by the atmosphere. So Hubble is a telescope which is there in the space, and it is capturing outer space objects. But the problem was the lens which was used was incorrect. There's a fraction difference in the way it was made, so it was creating blurry images. It was a nearly $1 billion project, but the outcome was blurry. So scientists used image enhancement techniques to correct that error, and you can see the error here. This is the blurry image provided by the Hubble, and by using image enhancement techniques, NASA scientists were able to clear that. This is the Hubble telescope positioned in space, capturing the outer space objects, and it's quite big actually. You can see the solar panels and communication ports on it. Second example for DAP techniques is in artistic effects, like in movies or in newsrooms or even in images that you capture for marriages or photo shoots. They are used to make images more visually appealing, to add special effects and to make composite images. So in this example, they have done extensive post-processing to highlight what detail they want to be highlighted, like the background is made more darker and the foreground objects are visible clearly here. And in this, they are using a green screen, and here they are using a blue screen so that they can replace the background later. Whatever scenery they want to add can be added in the background, maybe a CGI or a scenery or a hill or a war or a scene of a war, anything they can add in the background. So another important application is in the field of medicine, and here in this example what's happening is this is a slice from MRI scan of a dog heart, canine heart, and we are trying to find the boundaries between types of tissues. So using this application we can find whether that tissue is damaged or not. We are just using suitable filters to highlight the edges here. So you can using this technique you can identify whether there's a tumor or there's a damaged tissue and so on. We use DAP techniques extensively in medical field. Another application of DIP is in the field of geographic information systems, or simply GIS. So here we use the DIP techniques to manipulate satellite imagery. We can do terrain classification, like whether it's a dry area, it's a desert or a forest area, or whether it's a sea or a lake, anything we can classify using this. Or we can do meteorology, like we can predict what's going to happen, whether there's going to be a tropical storm or a clear sky day. And this is a image of a same place, and it has been taken using different radio sources, like different light sources and electromagnetic spectrum. Like this is 1, 2, 3. It could be RGB, and this could be near infrared or middle infrared, maybe ultraviolet, maybe some other radiation. So the idea here is, when we use only the spectrum which is seen by humans, we may not get all the information. So we can go for other spectrums also, like near infrared or infrared or any other spectrum, and basically cameras can capture wide range of spectrum outside visual limitation. Like humans can only see from red to blue, green is in the middle, but cameras can see beyond that range. And when we capture images using the other spectrum, we can get more information. That is the idea here. So this is another image of a storm over United States. So this is another example of GIS, but here the pic is taken at night, and by using this image which captures the light illuminating from a particular area, like this is North America and this is South America, and you can quite clearly see North America is fully occupied. Like you can see human settlements throughout the United States and Canada and even Mexico here. It shows you the population distribution. The brighter the area is lit, that means more densely populated that part of the world is. And in the south of America, you can see this is the Amazon rainforest area, and it's dark. That means settlement is less. Okay. Another example of DIP is in the field of industrial inspection. Here, in some cases, human operators may be somewhat expensive and slow and unreliable. So we can make the machines to do the same job more effectively, more efficiently. And already we have this industrial vision systems in various kinds of industries, like this one. This is electronics industry with this is a PCB layout, and you can see that it is having lots of components. So you can make the machines to inspect whether there are whether there is any missing component, or if the solder joints are acceptable or not, and any other faults can be identified. And in the field of pharmaceutical industry, you can make the machines to identify whether there's a missing capsule in the strip. And in bottling industries, you can check whether the bottle is full or not. Or in plastic industry, you can check if there is a unwanted bubble in a clear plastic, or in cereal, in food processing industry, you can inspect whether there is any unwanted thing mixed up with the cereals, or this is a eye implant, and you can inspect whether it's proper or not. So this is some of the examples in industrial inspection. Another example of DIP is in the field of law enforcement. Here, we can use the image processing techniques to identify the number plates, or we can identify the criminals by their fingerprint. You just do the fingerprint analysis, match it with the template, and determine who is the culprit. So, and we can use the DIP techniques to enhance the CCTV footage to identify the criminals who have entered. You can make the system automated to tell whether a criminal has gone through certain public areas. Several advanced algorithms are used in many countries to identify, to automatically identify the persons in public places. Another application of digital image processing is in the field of human computer interface. Here we can make the make human computer interface more natural. You can perform face recognition and gesture recognition. Basically, you can use the gesture recognition to do gaming also, where you can play interactive games, like just stand in front of a monitor and move your head or hand, and the computer will automatically detect what you are instructing, and you can play the game. And here in this example, you can see the computer is identifying the face and it's recognizing the persons. Energy sources for images. Apart from visible spectrum is the ones which humans can see, which is the RGB spectrum, RGB rays, red, green and blue. Apart from that, the cameras or sensors can be made sensitive to a variety of radiation. Like here, it can capture from gamma rays to radio waves. And in between, we have X-rays, ultraviolet, infrared, microwaves, and radio waves. So all these things can be captured by sensors. But humans can only see this visible spectrum. So that is one thing to remember. And one more thing is, apart from the electromagnetic spectrum, we can also have other energy sources like sound, ultrasound. Basically, you can capture magnetic field, or you can capture the electron energy, and some other sources like seismic energy. So let's look at the thing we can do with the other rays, like gamma ray. You can use it for bone scan, or else positron emission tomography, where you can see the functioning of tissues or organs, or you can see the outer space Cygnus loop, or you can check the reactor wall for safety checks. And the external source can be radioactive isotope decay, and and internal source can be nuclear reaction. X-ray is quite obvious or ubiquitous, we can say. Like it is used in variety of applications, like for X-ray for medical purpose, like chest X-rays illustrated here, or angiogram to identify if any vein is blocked near the heart, or you can do the PCB inspection to check for a discontinuity in the connections or missing components or any other faults. You can do the head CT, or you can also picturize the Cygnus loop, which is a defunct supernova in the outer space. And the source for it is X-ray tube or star nuclear reaction, for especially for outer space object capturing. Another electromagnetic spectrum that we can use for photography is ultraviolet radiation, and it makes use of the fluorescence phenomena, using which we can see some microorganisms or some objects which exhibit fluorescence, means they glow under the ultraviolet radiation. One example is the normal corn, and if it is affected by a virus or some infection, and it gets deteriorated, and we can clearly see it using the ultraviolet radiation. And also we can use it to capture outer space objects like this Cygnus loop. And you are all aware of the ultraviolet rays being used for fake node detection, which basically if in every high value node there will be some material embedded which glows under ultraviolet rays. Visible rays, visible light and infrared, we can mix infrared with the visible spectrum to get some really interesting images, which gives us more information. And there is a property associated with each wavelength, like humans can see this visible blue spectrum, visible green, and visible red in this wavelength 0.45 to 0.5 to up to 0.90 micrometer, up to 0.69 micrometer wavelength. And each band or each ray has its own property, means it will depict something. Like the visible blue depicts maximum water penetration, visible green shows you good shows you plant vigor, visible red gives you vegetation discrimination, and the invisible band, which is humans cannot see this infrared bands, but they are good in measuring something, like this near infrared in the band of 0.76 to 0.90 micrometer is good for identifying biomass and shoreline mapping. Middle infrared is useful for moisture content of soil and vegetation. Thermal infrared can measure soil moisture and thermal mapping, measure or show soil moisture or thermal mapping. And middle infrared is a good for mineral mapping. And these are thematic bands in the NASA's Landsat satellite. And here see band 1, band 2, band 3 visible blue, green and red, and this is 4 near infrared, and 5 is a middle infrared, 6 is a thermal infrared, and 7 is again middle infrared red in another band. And you can see it is showing the same area, Washington DC, but you get different appearance. You can see a river here, but its surrounding is different under different bands, and we can club them in a different way. We can we will go through this again in module 4 when we learn about color image processing, how mixing different bands work. Okay, this is just introduction. This is one more example of using infrared, and this is a multispectral image. You can create image out of multiple spectrums. Maybe you can club x-rays and infrared and visible spectrum, any component, and create a composite image like this. This is a multispectral image, and in this example they are depicting Hurricane Andrew taken by the NOAA GEOS satellite. And here they are mixing visible rays with infrared to map the storm or the hurricane. Images can also be created by tracking the magnetic waves, and in this example you are seeing a MRI image. MRI means magnetic resonance imaging, and it gives you a clear indication of what's happening in a knee joint or in a spine, and you can clearly track the bone and the tissue in between all the other muscles, and the doctors can diagnose what's wrong or what treatment needs to be done for this. We can also create images using seismic waves, and seismic imaging is a useful tool that basically bounces sound waves off rock structures underneath to reveal a possible crude oil or natural gas bearing formations. So in this example you can see a arrow mark here, so which is indicating a hydrocarbon trap. This hydrocarbon may be a gas or a oil, and the seismologists are using ultra-sensitive devices called geophones to record the sound waves as they echo within the earth, and then they can create a map, and then it's basically a image. One of the most popular medical imaging technique is ultrasound, and we can use the ultrasound to show a baby in the womb and to study how the baby is doing, whether any defects is are there or not. And also it can be used to study thyroid or muscle layers for some lesions. And basically ultrasound imaging uses high frequency sound waves to view inside the body. So we send the ultrasound waves, and we sense the reflected waves using sensors and create a image, and it can be viewed in real time. So you can see during imaging process you can clearly see how the blood is flowing through the vessels, or how the heart is beating, or how the baby is moving. Every thing can be seen in real time using this. Another type of image that we can create is synthesis images. Here we create a image from some form of image description. So based on the description we can create an image using mathematical equations or modeling. And so this is a simple image created out of circles. You can draw it on your own also on your notebook. I think many of you have done this already. this kind of images. So this is a synthesis image, and if you take it one step further with more mathematical modeling involved, you can create any kind of images that you want. Okay. To summarize what we studied till now, first we have looked at what is the digital image, what is digital image processing, history, and state of the art examples. In the next lecture, we'll be learning about fundamental steps in digital image processing. Okay, see you at the next lecture. Thank you.